Hi Trader, Tina here once again from ShortMeTina.com with my typical nightly recap. If you're new to the channel, drop a comment, say hello, let me know how you found me, let me know your name, say hi, I always say hi back. And if you're recurring, you already know what it is, you guys are my lifeline. Thank you so much if you're returning. I really can't thank you enough, I truly can't, it's well received. Let's just kick right into our video recap. As usual, we start off with the overall markets, the S&P 500. Again, if you're new to this channel, this might be unfamiliar to you. If you're returning, you already know what I'm going to say. So we're off today, closed at 275.08. Spent the last 4 days in decline, but we sort of expected that, right? Because the SPY ran into resistance when it hit 281.87, and you know what happens when a stock or an ETF or anything runs into resistance. Resistance can be representative of a wall, and it's usually marked by selling, and that's what we see in the case of the SPY. And so in my previous videos, let's say going back 2 to 3 weeks, I said, well, we need a pullback, because since bottoming in December, right, we rallied something like 20%. We were up about 20%, I think. Do the math, I'm not sure, but it's an insane amount in like a short period of time. And I said for us to continue on an upward trajectory in a very sort of stable way, right, the overall market does need to pull back. So I'm actually glad to see this pullback here. And even if we correct more, we're sitting here at 275.08. Don't be surprised if we correct all the way back to 260. If we do that, it would not invalidate my bullish thesis or the chart in any which way, right? If we break December lows, obviously we're in trouble and definitely look out. But if we correct to 260, I think everything is all in well. And I do believe if we correct further, you should be looking for opportunities in the market, right? You want to buy stocks when they pull back, good stocks, right? You want to use that as an opportunity. So let's cap it there. Right. What else do we have? So we have the IWM daily chart. Similar story, ran into resistance or came relatively close to resistance. We can say resistance clocks in at around 160 for the IWM. We went as high as 159.50 before pulling back. Like the SPY, we spent the last 4 days in a decline, closed at 151.68. So we closed relatively close to the low of the day. Today's low, we came in at 151.37. So going into tomorrow, I'm going to be paying attention to that level. If we break on volume and then can't seem to rebound, then more than likely we're going to retest 142. And in that, in such a scenario, in my opinion, it would be a good and healthy move to start buying, stocks that you've been paying attention to that you just have not been able to get in because they ran away from you. I'd use that opportunity to start buying stocks, good stocks in increments. That would be my plan at any rate. What else do we have? And then we have Weight Watchers daily chart, off about 6% on the day. Not surprising, we closed at 1944. After this gap down that the stock experienced late February, I said, well, expect your relief rallies, right? And then we had 2 days of rallies, I think, or the stock rallied for 2 days. That's a better way to frame it or phrase it. And it was up those 2 days, something like 15%. But I cautioned, I said, well, you're going to expect those relief rallies. If your stock gaps down by 20-30%, you're going to have that pop. So you can like put that down as a lesson. If a stock, a decent stock, declines, 20-30%, you're going to have like the following, either the subsequent day or the next 2 days or the next day, it's going to be followed by like a good 9-10% move. That happens. It's a good spot to go long when a stock sheds like 20-30%. But, it should not take away from the overall, the overall outlook of the stock, which is it's remained in a decline dating back for the past 2 years, right? Since topping out at around 100, the stock has done nothing but decline. So sitting here in 1944, I'd be paying attention to the most recent low of around 1880. If it breaks that, I think it can spiral and get really ugly. What else do we have? We have JD daily chart, off about 4%, closed at 27.84. So I like JD. Like I said, I like JD above $19. We got in around 19 to 20. That was our buy area. Saw it shoot up to 29. It's now pulling back to 27.84. I think another buy opportunity, if you're not in this stock and you're looking to get in, I think it's going to present itself with another buying opportunity. You just have to be able to see it and then capitalize off of it, right? I know sometimes it's scary when stocks decline, right? You know, even a stock you want to get into, when you see a decline for some reason, you no longer want to get in the stock or you're afraid to get in the stock. And I want to say that, you know, scared money, like, I don't know how the expression go, like, scared money don't make no money, whatever. It's kind of true, especially in the stock market. So when you see a trade that fits your criteria and your setup and you want to take the trade, you have to learn how to take the trade no matter what. And so for JD, it's pulling back, but I think it's presenting itself with another buy opportunity. What else do we have? ACB, it's managed to hold above high four, low fives for quite some time, right? Dating back to October of 2017, well over a year, with the exception of this little anomaly that happened back in August. So we definitely know that four or five, based on that, comes in at around, that's support. If it can stay above there, it's good. We pulled back a little bit today, off north of 4% on decent volume, close at 758. So volume is there. I think another buying opportunity, as with JD, is presenting itself with ticker ACB. I like it. What else do we have? So we have CRON daily chart. Closed at 22.31, off about 2%. Again, full disclosure, I should have done a gazillion full disclosure, because a lot of the stocks I just rehash, you know, we took a position in it. For example, we're short the SPY. We've been buying the IWM in increments. Waiting on the sideline with JD, rather with Weight Watchers. JD, we got in at around 19. We're not in ACB. We took a position in CRON way back in August. And I like CRON, I like the marijuana space, mid to longer term. I think there's going to be a lot of volatility in the shorter term. At any rate, just focusing in on this candle today, I don't like it. Volume was kind of light, so this candle might be misleading, but pay attention to the low, 22.05. If we take that out, right, on volume, there's a good chance we're going to revisit this area here of $18. And even if we don't revisit, I think we're going to revisit it at some point, because it's been gravitating to here, right? You can just see it here. The stock continuously pulls back to that area. So I'm expecting it at some point. It could be tomorrow. It could be Monday next week. I do expect it to pull back to 18 at one point, which might be good, because it means chances are it's gearing up for it to retest the most recent high of 25.10 and then go on. Again, I do believe CRON at some point will be trading in the 30s, if not more. What else? All right, so Plug kind of sort of did what I anticipated it would do, being that it closed around 180, rather it closed at 181 yesterday. Today we had a bit of a sell-off, went as low as 155, but then buyers step in, drove the price of the stock up. We closed here at 197, which is a very decent close considering the high of the day was 198, with confirming volume. Going into tomorrow, I'd be paying attention, we can say to $2. If we can break that $2 level on volume, you can expect a really quick shoot to $2.20. So a little bit of upside. I'm not sure if it's worth it considering what's the potential downside, but that's what I see with ticker Plug. What else? All right, so ticker BPTH, I was extremely busy today. So I saw what was going on. So I did a video on BPTH yesterday, and I said, well, definitely put it on your watch list. These are the type of stocks, right? These are the type of stocks that give out like life-changing fortunes, right? It had the ability, I said yesterday, had the ability to run 100, 200%. Encourage everyone to pay attention to the most recent high of 1460, anything above there, and it was ready to run out the gates. And so this morning, I saw the trading in pre-market, and I don't know why I didn't act on the trade for some reason. I guess maybe because I had a lot of running around to do, and being that the stock is so volatile, when I trade these types of stocks, I like to actually be in front of a computer versus, you know, just putting in the order and going about my business, which I generally do because I'm a swing trader, but for BPTH, I knew there's going to be an extreme amount of volatility, and that's what happened today. Granted, we closed at 38.86, but we went as high as $73.52, right? So that's a huge move with this particular stock. So bit of a sell-off. I would still encourage folks to keep it on their radar. It's, I mean, if you can take the extremes and the volatility, obviously stay away from this stock. But it's going to be very tricky jumping into here, jumping into the stock. I'd have to look at it. Actually, let me do it. I'll pause for a second. Let me look at it in a smaller time frame. All right. So for the smaller time frame, so this is an hourly, it's an intraday chart, hourly. So I would say that support here comes in. So a good area to long, in my opinion, would be low to mid 20s. But obviously, be very cautious. I think today the stock was halted around 3 or 4 times. And there are times where stocks are halted indefinitely. So don't throw, you know, tens and thousands of dollars on this, because you can end up in a situation where your monies are locked up for an extended period of time. And when trading actually resumes, usually what happens is that these types of stocks fall flat on their face. So if you're going to take the trade, just be cautious. And again, bear in mind that it was halted about 4 times today. And again, sometimes I've seen situations where stocks are halted indefinitely. You don't want to have your monies locked up. But BPTH, in my opinion, still in play. I would look to go long somewhere in the 20s. I think that's a decent area of entry. What else do we have? All right, CIFS. So it kind of started to rev up a little bit when BPTH started to run, but I guess all the monies were already in BPTH, and so this one didn't get that oomph that it had a few days ago. So we're sitting here at 445, and again, I still think that this is a runner the same way BPTH ran, maybe not quite that way, but this can still put up 100 or 200% in a day as well. Because if you remember, like I indicated before, we ended up getting into this trade a few days ago with a buy zone of around 2, and we quickly saw it shoot up to $6, right? Representing over 100% in gains. It has still pulled back, but the fact that it's managed to hang around 4, and you don't, if you look at volume, you don't see like an outpouring of people trying to get rid of the stock. So whoever's holding it up is holding it up, and I can only assume that they're holding it up for another push and another run. So keep this on your radar. I'm gonna like put this somewhere like on my, I don't know, on my desk, which is very close, that there's a constant reminder to check on the stock, because I don't think it's done yet, just based on what I'm seeing. So yeah, CIFS, put it on your watch list. What else do we have? And we're gonna round it out with ticker AVGR daily chart. Let's just focus in on price action going back to October 18th. We're up nicely, 7% on the day, closed at 63 cents. The stock has been in an uptrend since late December. We're in March right now. So for 3 months, the stock has been in an uptrend. And what's an uptrend? It's characterized by higher lows, right? You see it here, higher lows. The lows just keep getting higher. The daily lows, weekly lows just continues to get higher. So you had the pullback a couple of days ago, and remember, no stock goes up in a straight line. You do have your pullbacks, and that's okay. So even if AVGR pulls back, let's say to this breakout base of around 42 cents, that's okay. As long as it doesn't dip too much below 40 cents, if it, in fact, I would argue it shouldn't dip below 47 cents, right? If it dips below there, the story is kind of getting a little wishy-washy. But if it can stay above, let's say 47, 50 cents, I think the story is still intact. What I would pay attention to is the most recent high of around 71 cents. If it can break that on volume, and you see volume has been pouring in as well, as the uptrend continues, volume is coming in. If it can break 71 cents with volume, a dollar is in the card. So that's still another potential 40 cents of upside, or 40%. So AVGR, AVGR, yeah, I said it right. Not my kind of stock, because it's a penny stock, but overall, you know, for the last 3 months, it's been acting relatively bullish. As long as it can stay above 47 cents, I'd be paying attention to that. 71 cents, if it can break that on volume and hold, a dollar is not far out of the cards. So we're going to cap it there. Tina from ShortMeTina.com. If you enjoyed any portion of this video, I would like for you to do 3 things for me. 1, comment. Are you in any of these trades? Do you want to get into any of these trades? Have you lost money, made money? What? Let me know. If you're new to the channel, like I indicated before, say hello. Drop me a line. I'll say hi back. If you're returning, just say hi. I just like to know that there, well, I can visibly see through viewership that folks are listening and through like the subscribes, but you know, I want folks to engage, right? So say hi. I will say hi back. And then secondly, if you want to hear more of this, definitely hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications. Again, I do videos Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. And if you turn on notifications and you hit that subscribe, when I upload, you'll be notified. Before I get to the third thing, I'm going to insert so everyone knows. Friday's video will actually be posted in the morning. So I'm going to do Friday's video either midday or before market open. I'm not sure, at some point in the day, probably a midday recap. So don't expect a nightly video. I'm going to actually do the video midday because I'll be away for the weekend. And, you know, after hours on Friday, I'm going to be like in the skies flying. I wouldn't, you know, I'm not going to have access to my equipment to record a video. So that I want to make note of that. And then the last thing is, if you want more content, again, I've been trading or involved in the stock market north of two decades. I want to say 17 years. It's been an interesting relationship I've had here with the markets. So if you want to learn more about the stock market, definitely head on over to our website, ShortMeTina.com, and sign up. Again, there's things that I share with my emailing list that I do not share with everyone else. So if you're new to trading and you want to hear more stuff, definitely sign up. I think it'll benefit you at the end of the day, right? You want to learn from someone who's been in the game for a very long time, not someone that's just been trading for, I don't know, 5 or 6 or 7 years. Like, there's a reason why I said CFIS, if you go back a week or two, was going to put up 100-200% gains. There's a reason why I said BPTH had the ability to run 100-200% in one day, not 5 or 10%. See the figures that I threw out, right? 100-200%. It put up about 500-600% today. There's a reason why we went short the market when it started to collapse. There's a reason why we held on to our short despite the run up, right? There's a reason why we were also the reason being is that a lot of this, right, while it's new, a lot of it's just an old script, right? It's things that I've seen time and time again. And I'll cut it there. I'm kind of rambling now, right? So thank you for listening, and as always, thank you for listening.